Hello there, this is Dr. Edward Park from Recharge Biomedical Clinic, and this is the video post accompanying the blog post of September 26, 2010. This post is related to premature aging syndromes, and we'll be jumping around a bit, but basically we're going to try to explore this mashup, which I did, showing the 11 premature aging syndromes. We will leave out Ehrlers-Danlos, which is a little bit of an anomaly, and notice that the other 10 syndromes have to do with DNA processing and repair. Specifically, these top 6, I guess, have telomere shortening as a prominent feature, whereas these bottom 4 do not. Other clinical features are shown here, and classically, this group shows what we would consider premature aging, the kind of which you might have seen in kids that are often featured in Make-A-Wish Foundation, who actually die of complications related to old age, often before their 12th birthdays. So what are these blue things, helicases? Well, helicases are little enzymes that are required to unzip the DNA for different reasons, including copying or replication and transcription. Here's a video explaining that.
When DNA replicates, its strands are separated by the enzyme helicase. Single-stranded DNA binding proteins keep the strands from re-annealing. One DNA strand encodes the leading strand, which forms from its 5' to its 3' end, using DNA polymerase 3. No problem here, but the lagging strand presents problems. It has to form from 5' to 3' too.
Okay, well, that starts to go into a very interesting topic called replicative senescence, which is also featured on my website, rechargebiomedical.com. An explanation of that can be found here in the telomere section, and there's a lot of other content which would interest you if you're considering telomerase activation or if you just want to learn more about what causes aging. This is an explanation of what replicative senescence means. But the bottom line is that every time a cell divides, the ends get shorter. And because we have these long ends called telomeres, that process doesn't immediately damage the informational part of the DNA. All right, so helicases can cause a problem. What about this one in yellow, Hutchinson-Gilford? Well, this progeria is due to a failure in the nuclear membrane protein called lamin A. I think I have a picture of lamin A here. This kid, unfortunately, is suffering from Hutchinson-Gilford progeria. And in the top picture, we see what a normal nucleus should look like. When the lamin A protein is somewhat abnormal, it forms this collapsed sort of nuclear membrane, which is a poor scaffolding for separating and sorting the DNA, as is required every time a cell divides. The structure of this nucleus gets even worse as this poor patient gets older, leading to all the problems we would associate with premature aging. Here, in green, we see the one progeria which is specifically related to telomerase dysfunction. Typically, what that means is the telomeres are cranked out here by this machine. It's kind of like a nano machine. And here's the end of the chromosome, and it's just pumping out more telomeres like a ticker tape. This is sort of the key to the engine here. It's the RNA component, and this part, this carin, is what is messed up oftentimes in the dyskeratosis congenita featured here. So the inability to produce more telomerase leads to premature aging. In red, we see the DNA repair problems, which are related to DNA and specifically telomere repair. What we know is that in the cell cycle, you have division, the first part of the cell's life, and then there's a checkpoint to see whether all the chromosomes are intact and if they're properly capped at their telomeres. This is followed by a S phase where the DNA and all the chromosomes are copied, and there is a phase where, once again, the checkpoint looks over and makes sure that everything is copacetic. G2 is the second phase of the cell, and then here at the end of G2 and the beginning of cell division or mitosis, there's another checkpoint. What is a checkpoint? Well, a checkpoint is when various enzymes, such as P53, see if there's any breaks, uncapped ends, or stalled replication forks. Any kind of bad stuff with the DNA requires the watchman, P53, to either kill or apoptose that cell, perhaps repair it, or put it into cell cycle arrest, which is basically hypnotizing it to go to sleep. And part of the reason why our metabolism's slow may be because a lot of our stem cells, after suffering damage, are being hypnotized to sleep. All right. Finishing up here, we have DNA transcription syndromes, which basically involve the ability to detect typographical errors and then remove them and repair them. So what do we notice with all these syndromes that result in premature aging? They all relate to failure to maintain telomere length, failure to remove errors, and failure to properly cap and protect DNA. And when that happens, DNA can fuse in bad ways, and the very process of cell division will cause them to be further damaged. I'd like to close with a very interesting video here, which I think explains a lot.
It's unzipping the double helix and copying one of the two strands. The yellow chain snaking out of the top is a copy of the genetic message, and it's made of a close chemical cousin of DNA called RNA. The building blocks to make the RNA enter through an intake hole. They are matched to the DNA, letter by letter, to make an exact copy of the A's, C's, G's, and T's of the gene. The only difference is that in the RNA copy, the letter T is replaced with a closely related nucleic acid known as U. You are watching this process called transcription in real time. It's happening right now in almost every cell in your body.
Okay, now that is very interesting. And I hope it illustrates that this is a very mechanical process. And what we're looking at when we seek to activate telomerase is to go ahead and make the ends more protected. So if you'll go over to the website at Recharge Biomedical, you can learn more about what causes aging. And this will include my own theory of telomere shortening as it applies to stem cells. And of course, there's lots of content regarding the safety, the cancer question, whether it's anabolic, like some things people take, such as testosterone or growth hormone. And you can see here, speaking of gene transcription, that all the genes that are upregulated by TA65 are known, and there's just a handful of them here, all of which involve replication, copying, and cell cycle control, meaning maintaining a good and healthy DNA repair mechanism. So to close, these DNA repair failures and telomere failures all result in premature aging, which is associated with cancer and other organ dysfunction. So we're left with the conclusion that really the final common pathway for much of what we would describe as diseases of aging goes through failure in proofreading, copying, and properly killing off error-ridden stem cells. This is Dr. Edward Park completing his lecture on Progerias, and I hope this has been interesting for you. I look forward to any comments. Thank you.